Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Now, if you've been following along on this rebuild series, you know that we've replaced all the seals, we've pressure tested, we've refilled our lower unit. Well, guess what? Now today, we're gonna remount it to the power head. Let me go grab a couple of basic tools, then we'll get this thing knocked out. So, let's go. Now, before we carry it over to the power head, we do need to reattach the extension. Otherwise, this isn't going to work out very well because this is actually one of the long shaft units and it has this piece. Really simple to do. Get those dowels lined back up. And now she's ready to go. Just be leery when you go to lift it up. Don't grab it here, otherwise it's just going to fall right out. You have to make sure you grab the actual lower unit part and not the extension. Now, before we carry it over, there's two things we need to do. We need to go ahead and grease the input shaft splines, and then we need to make sure that our bolts are within arm's reach, because once you manhandle this thing over there, they need to be close, otherwise you're going to be stuck. So let me grab a little bit of grease, get these splines lubed up, get my bolts nearby, and then we'll get this thing reinstalled. I'm just spreading it around the rest of the length of it, just to keep it from corroding. Now there's already grease around our coupling down here, and we should be good to go on the shift shaft. We'll put a little bit more down in there. So we've got our nuts and our bolts in place. When we bring it over, we're just gonna get one of these on there without the washers. At that point, we can shimmy it the rest of the way up, then go back, add a washer, and then bring it up into position. Now, the real challenge here is this little speedo tube that's all the way at the front of the lower unit. And the real challenge with this one is it has that extension on it. So I have to get my hand down in there and kind of do it by feel. Make sure we're grabbing it down low far enough. Oops. Let's hold it there for just a second. All right, she's pushed in. Now we can bring it up, align your shift shaft. We've got one holding it in place. Let's go ahead and start putting in the other nuts with washers. And we're just gonna bottom them out, and then we're gonna come back around and torque everything down. Now it's time to get these torqued. And the nuts along with the one in the bottom all go to 55 foot-pounds. Now the one in the back is pretty easy. Now how in the world am I gonna get that in there? Well, let me show you something. We're gonna use this little adapter from Motion Pro where you actually clamp into it with this little device. We're going to tighten those down. Guess what that is? That is a 3/8 drive. Now, if you do this at 90 degrees, it doesn't matter where you place it on the wrench. Now, if you're going to be off axis, well, then you have to get out a calculator and figure out how much you need to reduce or increase your torque by to get it correct. We're going to do it at 90 degrees. That way we don't have to do any calculations. So let's go. Now we have one last thing to deal with, and that is the anode. And we're actually going to go ahead and replace this one because it looks pretty rough. And to complicate things, the bolt that they had in there that was actually laying on its side, if y'all were watching that video, it's the wrong size. So there's two ways we can address this. If your anode is in good shape, then, well, all you have to do is rebolt it. And this would be the bolt that you would use to do so. Mine, on the other hand, is the wrong bolt and the anode is worn out. So Mercury also makes a kit that has the anode as well as the correct bolt. It is as if they knew. So let's get that in place and then torque it to 40 foot-pounds. Now with this extension, how do you really do that without it just falling in and laying down at the bottom? Let me show you a little trick to keep that from happening. Take some electrical tape and put it around the edge to where it barely overlaps on the socket and comes into contact with the bolt itself. Now don't put so much on there that it won't pull through and leave your socket down there as well. That's what we don't want to happen. Although we can retrieve it with a magnet later. You just want enough tape on that edge to keep it from falling away. Now, let's bring our bolt down. When the bolt comes from the factory, it's already got some blue Loctite on there. If you're reusing your bolt, go ahead and add Loctite to it. Switch over to our torque wrench. Set it to 40 foot-pounds. Torque it down. That's it. Now let's see if we can get that tape to release. Voila. Well, there you go. She's all bolted back and ready to go back in the water. Well, of course, after you put the prop back on. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, if you like what you see, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you'll be notified, well, with whatever I'm working on next. Once again, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.